gardeners, welcome back to my channel. My name is Trisha, and in today's video I'm going to be covering something that I should have covered a very long time ago, and that is how to tame a green tree python. So I get questions about Metamora all of the time, so it's kind of crazy to me that I'm just now filming this video, but at least it's finally happening, so hopefully this can help some of you guys out, because I know a lot of you guys are really interested in green tree pythons. However, you're nervous to get one because they're known for having very, very feisty attitudes, and they can be very nippy. And that is precisely the same reason I didn't even want to get Metamora in the first place as well, because I was very nervous about getting bitten and how to handle one, and I was just not comfortable with the situation. My boyfriend kind of pushed it on me. He really, really wanted to get one, and he's like, you can just do it. And I'm like, I don't know about that. Like, I'm kind of new to snake keeping. Like, I've only had Bowie for like 4 years, coming up on 4 years now. So I didn't feel like I was on that level. However, he got Metamora, and I kind of just had to suck it up and deal with it. And I learned so much from the whole experience, and I'm so happy to share that with you guys now. So right off the bat, I want to say that it's not so much about taming green tree pythons as it is understanding their body language. Because once you understand their body language, you can completely avoid getting bitten, and you can learn how to work with these animals. That way you aren't stressing them out to a point where they're going to be striking at you and biting you. So to start off, green tree pythons are known to be way more defensive than a lot of other snakes, and that is simply just because they are arboreal, meaning that they live up in the trees. So because of this, they're usually on branches out in the open, completely exposed and vulnerable to other predators. So because of this, they're gonna have to have a more defensive demeanor in order to protect themselves in the wild. It only makes sense, because a lot of snakes that we keep are usually in hides, and they burrow, and they just stay away from humans, whereas a green tree python is literally just out in the open. So when it comes down to it, a green tree python is going to strike at you for one of two reasons. It's either because it's striking at you out of hunger and it's trying to eat something and it thinks that you're feeding it, or it's just trying to protect itself because it feels threatened. They absolutely will never strike at you for their own enjoyment. That's not something that snakes do. They are just only trying to protect themselves or eat. It's all about survival with them. It's not a game. So a lot of people think that they are just really, really mean animals, when in reality, they're just trying to survive, protect themselves, and hunt, and that's all it is. And just by understanding that, you can already start to form a better relationship with your snake. So we are going to jump into taming these guys now, and I'm gonna start off with number one, and that is that green tree pythons are more of a look, don't touch type of animal. And I say that because it is possible to handle them, absolutely. However, it's best to just leave them alone, because they don't always want to come out. And when you're trying to force them to come out, that's when bites happen and they get very stressed out. And that's something that you want to avoid. Because they are arboreal, they are more defensive. It's just not an animal that you want to be going in and trying to take out every single day. It's absolutely not going to be good for your snake, and that's something that you want to avoid. The other reason that these animals are more of a look, don't touch type of animal is because they are very fragile and delicate, especially as babies. And the way that they coil themselves up on their perch, they literally wrap their prehensile tail around the perch. So you need to be very, very careful. You can never just like rip your green tree python while it has that grip, because you can break their prehensile tail, which is extremely, extremely delicate. It's very skinny. It literally looks like a skinny little worm, and they actually use it to like wiggle around to entice their prey right before they strike it. So it's really an interesting feature, but it also does make them vulnerable, especially in captivity, because people don't recognize how fragile that tail is. So because of all of these factors, it's very important to just recognize that this is not an animal that you're going to be handling all the time, and it's definitely one to just admire from afar and just watch it, because honestly, they're the most gorgeous animals, and they're so pretty that like you could watch them all day long. So you get enough enjoyment just from being able to see them in your home every single day, and that should be enough. If that's not enough for you, then this is not going to be the snake for you, and I would recommend getting something that is way more tolerant of handling, like a ball python or something. So the next thing when it comes to taming is that they will adjust and recognize you over time. There are certain things that you should do in order for your snake to learn you, and that is what we're going to talk about. So the first thing that you should do is keep a routine with feeding. I usually choose one day of the week specifically that is going to be designated as feeding day. And it's really interesting because your snakes actually kind of recognize this time frame and they have an understanding of when you're going to feed them. So it's really, really useful to do this. That way they have some form of routine. That way when they're hungry, they know that they're going to be fed soon and they're going to be less defensive with you because they're just hunger striking all of the time. So that's something to be aware of. The other thing that is important to do is repetition. So the way that you're going to be approaching them around their enclosure, whether you're just cleaning it out or doing some maintenance, refilling a water bowl, the best thing to do while you're doing all of this is completely avoid them. That's what I do with Metamora. Sometimes she'll wake up and get in a defensive position because she doesn't know what I'm doing. She doesn't know if I'm gonna feed her. She doesn't know if she has to protect herself, and that's completely natural. So when this type of a situation actually happens and I'm in the enclosure doing something and I don't want her striking at me as I'm doing something, I put her into flight mode. And the way that I do that is literally just spraying down the enclosure, which is another thing that you're gonna have to do every day with maintenance anyway. So while I spray the enclosure down, she actually like coils down even more because she doesn't really like being sprayed down. And it puts her in like a little bit of a flight mode. So while she's in that mode, she's not going to be defensive whatsoever. She's just kind of like, oh, okay, you're doing your thing. I'm going to inch away over here. And then it allows me to do the maintenance that I need to do. And again, she understands that repetition. She understands the misting down the enclosure. So it's not something that will stress her out because it's something that she expects to happen every single day. So repetition is just very, very important. Repetition and routine is the best way other than like feeding an animal when it comes to taming, because they understand you and what you're doing and they get used to that schedule and they don't see you as a threat. So it takes time and patience with this. Some animals are a little bit more scared than others, but if you continue to do this over time, they will adjust and they will understand what's going on. So the next thing I want to discuss is that babies are more feisty than adults. And this is for very important reasons. So babies are very, very, very tiny and vulnerable. Their tails are even smaller. They're just very, very fragile. So because of this, they're going to be more protective of themselves and way more defensive. And that's only natural. Most snakes are like that in the wild anyway that are babies. So it's going to be the same exact thing with green tree pythons. However, if you get one as a baby and you build that routine and repetition, they will start to learn you and understand you, and you can build that relationship. So I'm not deterring anyone away from getting a baby green tree python because, yes, they may not be as handleable and it may happen over time, but you're just going to have to be patient. Another reason why they are more nippy is because they are hungry little things. They want to eat, they want to grow, so they're going to be hunger striking because they may not fully understand that routine of feeding yet, and they may just be expecting food every single time you come to the enclosure. So those are two things to be aware of, and those are other reasons that people think that these animals are just so aggressive when really they're not. They're just protecting themselves, or they're hungry, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. So the most important thing when it comes to taming a green tree python is handling etiquette. So I created a few rules to follow as a guideline for this because it will definitely help when you are handling or trying to handle your green tree python to avoid getting bitten. So the first rule when it comes to handling etiquette is to never come above them. So never, when you're reaching for them or something, never go above them because they're automatically going to see you as a threat. In the wild, there are birds, there are things above them that are constantly going to be trying to eat them, grab them. Like, it is a very threatening position for them to be in a tree like that. So if you put a shadow over them, they're going to already freak out and they're not going to know what's going on. They're going to be very defensive. So if you're ever trying to like reach in or do something, always go underneath of them because going above them is going to significantly raise their stress levels. Number two is to never try and pull them off of a perch. So this, I feel like, is a matter of respecting the green tree python. A lot of people are used to being able to just go into their snake enclosure and grab them out. You absolutely cannot do that with a green tree python, again, because the way that they coil, they're gonna have that prehensile tail wrapped around their perch, and you absolutely do not wanna rip that off and hurt their spine whatsoever. Some people really damage their snake spines, and some of them die from it as well, so you just have to be very, very careful with these guys. The next thing that you need to do is be very patient and gentle with your movements. So green tree pythons are pretty slow moving animals when they do explore. They like to just like, they go in like a straight line sometimes and reach out. It's like really entertaining. I love handling Metamora so much. It's a lot of fun. She is very slow moving and it's very relaxing. You just need to make sure that you're being slow moving and relaxing with your snake as well. It's literally like a form of meditation. You just have to replicate your snake's energy and you guys will be set. If you are like grabbing them and like whipping them around and doing stressful things like that, they're not gonna like that, and they're most likely going to strike at you because they're gonna be like, what are you doing? And that is understandable because I would be like that too. So just be at one, be at zen with your snake, and you will have a much more successful handling session. The next tip is removable perches. So if you do have a very defensive green tree python, the best way to get your green tree python out is to be able to have access to taking the whole perch out. I actually don't have that in my enclosure, and I plan to do that in the future because it'll make life so much easier. But you can literally get like little notches that will hold the pole in, and you can just take the whole perch out, and then your snake is on a perch. And if they want to come off and slide onto you and you become their tree, that's totally up to them, and that's the way it should be. It should always be on their terms, which is my fifth tip as well. So again, you never want to be forcing your snake to have to come to you. Let them do it on their own terms because you just don't want to stress them out or hurt them whatsoever. And my last rule for etiquette when it comes to handling is to not overdo it. Don't try and take them out every single day. Again, this is not really a handling snake. If they are coming to you and want to come out of the enclosure as you're doing maintenance or something, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. However, you don't want to just be taking them out off of their perch every single day. It's not something that they're going to enjoy, and it may stress them out. So you just have to be respectful with it. Again, just appreciate that it's a beautiful viewing animal and not so much for handling. And once she's out, that's the other thing. People are worried about them just coming out. They think that they're gonna continually strike at you, which every single snake is different. Some of them may still be defensive. However, my green tree python, once she's out, she is completely relaxed. She accepts me as her tree. I'm respectful with her. I let her go where she wants to go. And I'm not grasping her very hard or like doing anything that she would not like. So she kind of just explores and enjoys her time on me when I have her out. So understanding their body language is another thing that's just really important with all of this. When they're in a strike position, you're gonna see the little S right behind their neck. When they're just giving you that sassy look and face, you're gonna kind of understand that they are in a defensive demeanor, and it's pretty obvious. They make it very obvious when they are about to strike, so it's something that you can understand over time. When they're in flight mode or when they're relaxed, they do not have that cocked neck whatsoever. It's just relaxed and in a straight line, so it's just, you get to learn their body language over time. The more that you work with them, the more you're gonna understand them, and the more you're gonna understand your individual snake and its preferences. So the last thing that I would like to mention in this video is that there is not one way that will work for all, because every single green tree python, while they all have a similar demeanor and behaviors, they each will have their own personality and preferences. And that's something that we need to attend to accordingly, depending on our snake. So if you do have a feisty green tree python that is just way more defensive, then that is definitely an animal that you obviously don't want to handle as much. And when you absolutely need to take the snake out, it's best to have a removable perch. If you have a green tree python that does enjoy handling or tolerates it, then it's something that you can try a little bit more often. Some of them seem to like coming out and exploring. It can be a form of enrichment. Again, you just want to make sure you're not overdoing it to the point that you're stressing your snake out. So you just need to be mindful of all of these things and very mindful of your snake in particular. That way you are able to give it a good life and not stress it out. So I hope that this video was helpful. Maybe you learned a couple of new things about green tree pythons. A lot of people just think they are just really mean snakes, and honestly, they are not, like, at all. Like, Metamora is just like the sweetest snake. She has never bitten me ever. None of my snakes have. And I think that it's fully just because I understand their body language. Once you can just understand your snake, it makes all of the difference. So if you are afraid of getting bitten, this may not be the snake for you. If you are up for the challenge, it is absolutely worth it because these snakes are just impeccable animals. I love them so much. So they are definitely worth a try. You just want to make sure that you are giving them the best life possible, and you don't want to put that at risk whatsoever. So if this is something that you're nervous about or you don't think that you can handle, then maybe put it off, get some more experience, learn some more about them before you actually make that leap and go get one. I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you guys so much for being here today, and I will see you guys in the next video.